Hi, I just wanted to let you guys know that the response for my version of fried chicken was absolutely overwhelming. I'm so happy to know that so many of you tried the recipe and got back with your feedback and pictures. So this time, I'm back with another recipe. It's gonna be a crowd favorite again. So let's set the pretext over here. You're going out with your friends pre-corona time to a restaurant. And what do they order the most? So my friends definitely order butter chicken the most, my non-vegetarian friends. So let's see if I can come up with a version that's going to be better than that of a restaurant. And I'm going to let my friends be the judge of that. So another thing that I'm going to teach you along with making this wonderful recipe is also how to multitask while doing it, because this is going to be a long recipe with several steps. So we're just going to try and learn how to do it in the most efficient way possible. So now at this stage, my oil is quite hot and I am going to turn it off. You do not want to smoke the mustard oil in this recipe because we want the taste to retain in it. In this cooker, what I'm going to be doing is preparing my gravy base. This is 500 grams of chopped up tomatoes. You don't have to take too much effort into chopping them perfectly. Roughly chopped is perfectly fine. So I have 100 grams of cashew nuts going in and roughly about 6 Kashmiri red chilies. I add only Kashmiri red chilies in this recipe because it gives the most wonderful color without adding too much of the spice. In restaurants, they do add onions in makhani gravy as well, but that's just to build the body of the gravy without using too many tomatoes. But I'm going to retain the authenticity and use only tomatoes in this case. I love that to come up to 6 vessels. So as the story goes, butter chicken was invented by accident in a restaurant called Moti Mahal in Delhi. So the chef there simply added some leftover tandoori chicken into basic tomato gravy and voila, that's it. That's how the recipe came into existence. But right now it's... Continuing with the marination of the chicken without wasting any time. I'm going to be adding 1 tablespoon of Kashmiri red chili powder into this warm oil to bring out some of the fantastic color that it has. And I'm just going to set it aside. 1/2 teaspoon of salt, 1 teaspoon of ginger garlic paste, and finally a good squeeze of some lemon. Now that my first marination is done, I'm just going to set it aside and go ahead with the marination of my curd. 1 teaspoon of cumin powder, 1/2 teaspoon each of coriander powder, garam masala, and kasuri methi. So what I've done here is I've dry roasted the kasuri methi and then I've powdered it because it makes it the most aromatic. So I'm just going to whisk this curd smooth first before I add my chili oil. So this is my last ingredient going in, it's my chili oil. And as you can see, the color is instantly transformed and it gives a beautiful orange color. This is simply because I added my chili powder into warm oil first. And that goes straight into my chicken. Finally, let's give that a good mix and ensure all the pieces are evenly coated. So now that my chicken has marinated, let's have a look at the tomatoes. So there's one tiny thing that I forgot to mention earlier. You must add 1/2 teaspoon of salt as well. So I'm just adding this at this point. And the next step would be to blend this to a fine paste, but I am going to allow it to cool down first. So what I've done here is I've emptied the contents of the cooker into a large bowl to allow it to cool much faster. And now that it has cooled, I'm going to transfer it to my mixer. We're going to strain this gravy base once. This is a very integral and essential step because this is what will give you a restaurant style silky smooth gravy. You're going to add generous 3 tablespoons of ghee into a hot pan. And go in with 1 tablespoon of ginger garlic paste. I'm going to add some Kashmiri red chili powder, 1 tablespoon of it. And then go in straight with my gravy base. And now going in with my milk. Now it's time to season the gravy. I'm going to add 2 tablespoons of sugar and 2 teaspoons of salt. If you do not have cardamom powder, the alternative that you can do is add some whole cardamom while boiling your tomatoes. So now that I've added all the ingredients for now into my gravy base, I am gonna cover it and I'm gonna simmer this for the next 20 minutes while I grill my chicken. Again, like I said, multitasking, efficient cooking, all that. Now that my gravy is simmering at the back, it's time to grill my chicken. At this stage, you want the pan to be really hot. So the chicken's grilling on a very hot pan and it's going to take roughly 10 minutes a batch. I have a large pan so I was able to accommodate all the chicken, but you do want to cook it for 10 minutes a batch and you want it to get the nice char marks on it or grill marks on it. It's fine if you do not have a grill pan, you can do it on a regular frying pan. So I am going to grill the chicken until it gets those char marks and then I'm going to smoke it with some coal. So let's just transfer all the chicken. You want to get all the burnt bits as well. And also any of the juices or oils which have been left behind, you want to transfer those to your pan as well. It is now time to smoke the chicken and end up with a result that tastes exactly like tandoori chicken. So I have a piece of very, very hot coal here. I'm placing that in a small bowl in the middle of all the tikkas. And I am going to top it off with a little oil. Now that it started smoking, I'm going to cover it and allow it to smoke for 2 minutes. Let's have a look at our tikkas. So in with my butter. A good squeeze of lemon. And finally chaat masala. Let's give that a good mix. So in all the time it's taken me to make this chicken and smoke it, so a total of 20 minutes. That's the time that my gravy has been simmering as well. Now it's time to finish the gravy and officially finish the dish. Roughly about 2 tablespoons of butter. Half a teaspoon of garam masala. So this is roughly 3 tablespoons of fresh cream. 1 tablespoon of roasted kasuri methi. So at this stage, this is our perfect makhani gravy, and instead of chicken, you could add any other ingredient of your choice like paneer or mushrooms or any other meat in fact. You can just make them into tikkas using the same marination. I know this seems like a lot of work and a lot of money for making chicken at home, but trust me, this is going to be even better than the hotel and you're going to end up spending as much as you do in a hotel to feed way more than 4-6 people. My butter chicken is ready and we have also ordered another portion from a restaurant. It's time to move on to the judging part of this. But before that, I need a small favor. Just like last time, we came up with a name like SFC for the fried chicken, but I couldn't think of a name this time, or neither could anyone else. So I really appreciate it if you could comment a few names and help us decide what to name this dish. Again, just like the last video, I am not going to tell them which one I made and which one we ordered. So let's try and get an honest review.
Action.
Wait. Now that our judges are here, it is time to compare my butter chicken with the restaurant butter chicken.
This one is nice. You know, that one chicken, nice grilled, and that feel and kadakide. So, ma, adukapra, idum nalla irukku. Idla konjam sugar content adhigama irukka maari feel aagudhu. Adha andha chicken oda andha grilled anadhu andha richness and the flavor ellame romba super ah irukku. So, I think idhu da sanjana pannadhu nu nenikiren.
எனக்கு வந்து இந்த ரெண்டுல இது வந்து ஹோம் ஸ்டைலிங்க செஞ்ச மாதிரி இருக்கு. ஏன்னா இது வந்து க்ரீமியா சில்கியா இருக்கு. அப்புறமா சிக்கனும் நல்லா குக் ஆயிருக்கு. அப்புறமா கலர் வைஸ் பார்த்தாலும் இது கொஞ்சம் டார்க்கர் ரெட் கலரிங் ஆட் பண்ண மாதிரி இருக்கு. இங்க ஆட் பண்ணாத மாதிரி இருக்கு. ஸோ இது கொஞ்சம் சம்திங் நான் செஞ்சது எனக்கு பார்த்துட்டு வரணும்.
So amongst the two for the result, as I think both of you had guessed, this is the one that I made and this is the one from the restaurant, so I win.
Yeah, if you really like the video, put up the thumbs up. Enna karmandadu
click the thumbs up.
If you do like the video, please
click the
subscribe.
Like.
Okay.
Action.
If you really like the video.
Action.
Say okay.
Action.
If you really like the video. If you really like the video, hit the thumbs up.
Share the video.
And help me decide in the comments what I should be calling this and also what you think of the video. And do subscribe to Cook TV.